Okay, so next up is René Saumseil.
Ja.
Talking about TKOO class like Richards. Go on. Okay.
So, I will talk about OO class like Richards. The work is done currently in a tip in inside TK. It's written upside. You have to look at tip 510, and you can find also on this tip, that's the page of the tip. Here you can find the description of what I have done. It started as an implementation of the RPC graph widget and the tkparse widget. When I tried to integrate these widgets into TK, I stumbled about the option handling, and I had to replace the old option handling in these widgets. But it was very, very difficult to do so, and so I decided to make a more easier approach to add and handle widget options inside widgets. You can find a binary of the current work, so you can test it out here under test binaries. There's a binary for Linux and for Windows. Let's go. Oops, where's my mouse? Wie komme ich raus? Ah, so. Okay. The OO class widgets have a common functionality. I decided to add the handling of the options in an existing method, so we don't have to learn new commands on new handling of widgets. You can see it here. They have the same syntax as the TK and the TTK widgets. It starts with a widget name and the path name, and if you have created a widget, you do it with path name, and then you call your methods. I have converted in an OO class like widgets in frame and label frame and in top level tool, so you can use these widgets as a starting point to develop own widgets. And the graph and the path widgets are now also already OO class-like widgets, so you can add your methods and options to it. So, let's go. So, I have implemented the already existing cget and configure methods, and all the option handling is inside the configure method. Normally, when you call the configure method, you have to provide either no arguments, then you get the current options, or you have to provide an option at first argument, and it started with a minus sign. And if it not start with a minus sign, currently it was an error, and I use the slot to add my own functionality for this. So you can now add new options, and you can add synonym options, you can add normal options with the name of the options, the database name, the database class. You can give it a default value and additional flags. Currently, it's only the read-only flag allowed. Then you can also delete existing options, and you can hide or show options. The internal handling of the option is done with a link to a tickle variable and a tickle array variable. And to get these variables back, you have here a name. You can call these option variable and bind it, for example, to other widgets. Then I have an internal function that is needed. When the widget is created, the options will be processed and the read-only options will be applied. And further on, you cannot change read-only options. but all other options can be changed. And I don't know where all options. If I add the new options, the read-only options will be set on creation time, and the other options will be set afterwards when all the hierarchy of our widgets are created. So you can have, for example, you have an TKO frame as your base class, and you add to it another class, and you use a TKO frame as a superclass. So, and you add options in your own class and other options in the TKO frame class. Then the init of the normal options is done after all your hierarchy of classes are processed. And this is done with a configure init option, configure init method. Then to provide own options, you have to create a method with a name of the option for each of your options. And because the hierarchy are OO classes, it's easy to intercept, for example, options. So if you have a background option in the frame and you will disable it, you can hide it, or you can also create an own background option method in your own class and maybe only allow red backgrounds or blue backgrounds, for example. The constructor uses two arguments. The first one is an option list. Here you can add your own options. And the second one is a normal argument list. That's now the internal working of the option handling. If you call in the get method with an option, it will look inside the internal C structure and get the value from the option back. If you call the configure method, you can add, delete, and do something with these options, and it will fill this internal structure and the variable, the array variable holding the options. You can access these variable inside from your methods. And the constructor of the TKO widget base class will also add the path name of your widget. So if you create a widget named .t, it contains the name .t in this variable. When you set an option via the configure method, then at first it will set this variable, and you can do it also in your own methods. And then I have a trace on this variable, and it will call in a C function, and this C function will check if it is a real option, otherwise it will provide an error. And if it isn't an option, it will call the option method. And this method could be a tickle method. It could be a Z method, a Z-coded method. And it could be an common option method provided for use for common options like relief or background or so on. And inside the option method, you can access the new value with the option variable, and you can also get the old value of the option with a cget method. So it's easy. You don't have to save your old state and check if it has changed also. Now we are on the C side. We have the common options. It's an enum. It's described also in the tip. You can look in the tip and look in the TKO widget man page, and it's described in detail there. So We have for different types of options enums defined, and you can use these to make some default actions for this. And for each option, we have the following structure. Here we have the option, DB name, DB class, and so on. The flags, it's an internal. And we have different I have shown you, we have different types of methods. We have tickle methods, and we have C methods, and we have common option methods. And you can provide it here. If it is a tickle method, it will show up here. If it's a C method, it will show up here. And if it's a common option method, then it will use these three variables to define the option. To define a new widget, we have to create a class and put our options in the class. And to make it easier, I have two structures. The first structure is holding the methods of the new class. And it, the first one is always the constructor, then the destructor. Then you can provide a list of common options and of public options and a list of internal options. And to define options, I have also a structure. And in this structure, I've shown here. And here I set a common option. It's the class option. And the class option doesn't need to be saved because we have the value of the option already in the array variable. And we can access it there, so we don't have to save it anywhere on Z side. And it's a read-only option here. That's also such an option. It's a common option. It's a pixel-related option. And I need the data of the object, the frame metadata from the object. And I have an structure in my frame holding all the values of the frame. And inside this structure, I have also an entry of the border bits. And that's the offset inside this structure. And here is the access to the structure. Oops, it's too viel. That's in simple synonym option. And here we have an option which is defined in an own C method. Okay. To define the options in the class, I have a function. This function uses as parameters the list of the methods and the list of the options. And it will take care of all the initialization of these. And it will create the methods in the class, and you don't have to worry about it to do it yourself. But it's also possible if you don't use this one, you can also do it by hand and make your own. The base class of the widgets, the TKO widget, contains the created widget. And to access this widget, there is a function. It will have as a parameter the current object, that's your widget, and it will return the TK window of your widget, which is created. And you have to check this window if it exists, and it's necessary, for example, if you have methods which are called from the event loop, you have to be careful if your widget already is existing anymore. And if you ask this parameter and it is null, if it's null, then the widget is already gone. Then you can with this function, you get the name of the global variable back, so you can access the variables. And here you can also get the current value on the C side. So how looks creation of a new class? The setup of the class is done in TCL. So it's also on C side widgets, it's done in TCL. It's always the same. You create your own class. And it has the superclass, the TKO widget. If you create a widget based on the TKO frame, then your superclass will be TKO frame, for example. Then you have to make the variable TKO accessible. If you don't do it, you have to create a statement variable TKO in each of your methods to access these variables. And it will provide an unknown method, and this method will take care of the handling of creation of new widgets. So we have the same syntax as in TK. Then here you can add with the aforementioned method, the methods and the options. So the constructor, that's the part where you really create your widget. It has to check at first for the correct calling. So you need two arguments. At first is the option list, and the second one is the argument list. Then it, you have to allocate your own structure for your widget. You have to set the object metadata, and that data are your created widget structure. You can insert own options in the option list, then you invoke the next one in the queue, and finally it will come to the TKO widget constructor, and it will take care of all the initialization of the options and handling of this. And that one is, as I have said before, to get the TK window of your class, of your widget, of your new widget, you have to use this function, and you have to check if your return word is null, then it doesn't exist. That can happen if something goes wrong in constructing inside. Then you don't get any structure back from the TKO widget. So otherwise, you have to check if the pointer you get is valid. So you get at first you get the pointer, and if the pointer exists, it's guaranteed that the pointer exists until your widget is destroyed. But the content of the pointer, the TK window, could be null. And if it's null, you cannot access anymore the widget. So the class, the creation is done with the OO class command. As shown before, you have to define a superclass, our array variable, the unknown method. And for each option, we have to define an option method. And we have also a TKO configure method. This method is called after you configure an option via the configure method. So sometimes it's possible, it's supported in widgets. You change a lot of options, and the redraw will only be performed after all the options are set. And that is taken care of the configure method. It will call this method, the TKO configure. So you can overwrite, or you can write your own method, and it will be called after the configure is done. Constructor and destructor. Yeah, in the widget constructor, the new window will be created, and the widget structure, the internal widget structure holding all the options and the internal data will be created, and it will create the option metadata. Then you can add all your options, and the widget constructor will also create an event handler for the destroy notify event. this is necessary to support the creation, the deletion of the widget. You don't have to care about anything. You only have to fill the destructor of your widgets. Everything else will be done inside the widget construct, the widget TKO widget. And it will create an trace variable, and trace on the TKO variable. And the option add will add options and so on. Okay, let's go on. Widget deletion. Widget deletion can occur on two passes. The first one is destroy our widget, and it will create an event. And this event will the widget event procedure, which was created in the create event handler for the destroy notify. And this procedure will check if you have a destroy notify and if the window exists. And then it will delete it even and it will destroy the window and it will set this TK window to null. So if you will be called, if your own destructor will be called, the window is null and you cannot access it anymore. And then it will call the destructor of the widget. And the destructor will be processed from the outermost widget to the innermost widget created in the class path, the outermost class to the innermost class. So, and in your destructor, you have to set your own metadata back. It's done with the last parameter set to null. And you always have to invoke next. So finally, it will come to the to the widget destructor here. And this one will delete all the rest and free also the widget structure and your destructor. When it set the metadata to null, it will finally call your metadata destroy function, and you can here free your created structure. So I have made some tests to show how many resources we need for this approach. And I've created many widgets and done some procedures. What I was expecting was that we are in the same range like normal widgets with a cget and configure method. Also expected was that we need some more time in creation of widgets. It's a little bit, in my opinion, it's too much. Maybe we can do something about it. But what I was not expecting was that the destroy of widgets is faster than on normal TK widgets. And the memory consumption for 1,000 widgets is here shown. So we need some more memory halt. So how can we do it on the TCL side? We can add new class methods to an existing OO class widget just with normal OO commands. You maybe know, someone can know it. And then we create a new widget with this, and we see if you run it, it will output the name here, and we see we have a new method to an existing widget. And then we can delete the method, and it's gone. And we can also done on the class level. So every widget will get the new method, and you can also change existing created widgets. So we use the already created widget here, and we add to the widget a method. And we see that the widget method exists. And if you create another widget with a formally defined class, then the object method doesn't exist. So it's shown that only exists on the object level. If we will create a widget in TCL, we have to define the subclass, the variable, and the unknown procedure. We have to provide a constructor with option list and argument list. And we have to call the next constructor so we can get finally go to the TKO widget constructor. And the first one is the option list, and we can provide our own option list here. And we have to define the option methods naturally. And then when we test it, we can see that we get the expected results. You can try it yourself on the provided binaries if you like. Here I show the use of the extended configure method. So the last page was showing how you can add new options to new methods to a class, and here you can add new options on the fly. So you have an existing frame widget here, and we define our new option method, and because it's defined later on, good. You have to define also the variable, and maybe you can look at these later on. Related tips to these functionality is tip 369. The widget cargo command. Here I have defined a widget cargo command, and you can use it. And I have defined it on class level and on object level. So, open issues. The current implementation of TIP 510 contains a TKO frame, label frame, top level, and the graph and pass widgets, OO class widgets. And for the last ones, for the pass and graph widget, there is already missing a MAC implementation. And we have also to decide which platform we will use for the pass widget, for example. It has different options here, and it would be an extension to TK. Currently, TK only uses an C compiler, and if you use, for example, GDE+, we need a C++ compiler to edit, and we need more external libraries for the Cairo platform. The next one is I still have to decide. Maybe you can help me in this. Should I split these TIP into two ones? In the TIP to add the OO class widgets, the widget support, and the RBC and graph widgets separately. Okay. And the next one is syntax. I have decided to make as little as possible impact. I have used an open slot to add the new functionality. It's done inside the configure method. And it could be done in a separate method also. Still undecided what to do about it. The class option definition could be have some sugar on it, maybe a special comment to do it. And also open is what's missing in a maker widget is it support would be component handling. You have the possibility, I think, in SNIT to add components to an existing widget. So, it's possible in SNIT to add components in an widget, and it will provide you some methods to access these components. For example, yeah, or you have a canvas and you have a header on the canvas or another widget, and so you have to build up your widget tree inside the OO class. Yeah. Other related issues are the handling of unique abbreviations of OO methods. Currently, if you use TK widget, you can abbreviate your method names, and it's not possible currently to do in OO. Maybe that's the work of Donald. Then the cget and configure could be also be added. This is the end. Could also add it to OO class and further options also. Thank you.
Good. Thanks, René. So, any more questions? Short round of questions? Or good. Did he answer everything already?
The current binary. They include the Decker bus and the graph
week. Yes.
It's only included.
Yeah. It's only Linux is Cairo based and Windows GDA plus.
Just noting that it's entirely reasonable to require C++ because we already require it for building on Windows, actually. Since some of the internal bits of the Windows implementation.
It's new.
Not really. It's just kind of hidden, the fact that there's a few bits and pieces inside there.
Hmm?
And equivalently on macOS, we require Objective-C.
Hmm?
So
since it's not a showstopper. That's not a showstopper.
It's not a showstopper.
Good.
It just slows down compilation times, because C++ is famously slow. But I don't think that's a problem if we're getting something good for it.
Mm-hmm.
And certainly having something like TK path, yes, that's something good.
First of all, thank you very much for doing that. And I'm very interested in the TK path part.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the future of this implementation? How does it at the end find into TK, or how can I get it now? What's the way for it?
It should go in TK. You should get it with a normal wish.
Yes, but not now.
Not yet.
Yet. I have built it with this tip. It's inside the TK repository,
okay.
And I can build it from these sources.
Ah,
it's okay. Already in the TK repository.
Ah, great.
Included.
Thank you.
And you can another feature maybe would be nice in Tickle and TK is to access your documentation. Let's have a look. Doku. This one. Currently, we have man pages, and we have no possibility to check the man page directly on the web. So we have to do some creation steps and create HTML and so on. But Fossil provide us the means, and I have written the documentation of the new widgets in Markdown, and you can access this documentation right out of the Fossil repository. No work done.
Okay, thank you.